This video contains descriptive video, throughout a hand, holding a pen, draws objects, words, and figures, starting with those of individuals engaged in different sports.
Hi there. Playing sports is a great way to have fun and be active. But to keep sports safe and enjoyable for everyone, it's important to know what to do if you or someone you know gets hurt.
A basketball player with twisted ankle falls to the ground, hitting their head.
You can see some injuries, like cuts and bruises. But others, like a brain injury called a concussion, don't show on the outside. Concussions are caused by a blow to the head, face, neck, or body from a fall, a hit, or anything that knocks someone hard enough that their brain moves around inside their skull.
Brain bounces around in the head.
This kind of brain injury doesn't show on x-rays, but concussions can affect the way you think, feel, and act. With proper care, people usually get better in a week to a month. But the effects of a concussion can last for months, or sometimes even more than a year. Concussions are really serious, so everyone involved with sports, athletes, coaches, team trainers, officials, teachers, and families, needs to learn how to recognize, manage, and even prevent them. It's really important to tell an adult, like a coach or a teacher, if you or someone else gets hurt. If you ignore a concussion, the injury might get a lot worse and the symptoms might last longer. Never tough it out or make someone else feel bad for saying they have an injury.
An athlete with a purple haze around her head says, "I think I'm fine." Her coach shakes his head in disagreement.
Telling someone is the smart thing to do, and it's part of being a good team player. There are things you can do to avoid getting a concussion in the first place. Step one is to learn as much as you can about concussions, like you're doing right now.
Website address, ontario.ca/concussions. A guide's title page reads, Concussion Awareness Resource, Rowans Law.
Next, you need to make sure you wear all the right equipment for your sport. Everything needs to fit properly and be in good condition. You also need to know and follow the rules. At the start of the season, you need to read and agree to your sport team's concussion code of conduct. Now, how can you tell if you or someone else might have a concussion? Most people don't lose consciousness when they have a concussion.
Observed by a volleyball player kneeling close by, a hurt player sits on the ground, a purple haze around their head.
So there are other signs and symptoms that you need to look for. The first things to check for are any red flags. These are signs and symptoms that might mean the injury is an emergency. Red flags include pain or tenderness in your neck, seeing double, weakness or tingling in your arms or legs, a really bad headache or a convulsion, loss of consciousness, or throwing up more than once. There are also red flags for how a person is behaving, like if the person becomes confused or keeps getting more and more aggressive or even angry. If these symptoms appear, then it's an emergency, and you or someone needs to call 911 right away.
The coach uses a cell phone to call for help.
Remember, concussions are brain injuries, and the brain controls almost everything we do and how we feel. This means that concussions can cause a number of different signs or symptoms. We usually group these into four categories: physical, thinking, emotional, and sleep-related. They might start right away, or they might take hours or even days to show up. Even if you have only one symptom, you might still have a concussion. Let's start with physical signs and symptoms. The most common is a headache. It could be pressure or pain. Some people even say it's like there's a power saw running in their head. You might also feel dizzy or nauseous, maybe even throw up. You might stumble around or lose your balance. Other symptoms include feeling like everything is too bright or too loud. Things might look blurry or you might hear ringing in your ears. You might feel tired, drowsy, or like you have no energy. Sometimes it can be difficult to describe how you feel. You may just know that you don't feel right. The thinking signs and symptoms are things like feeling confused or not thinking as clearly or quickly as usual. It might be hard to concentrate or remember things. Emotional signs and symptoms often include feeling upset or angry easily, feeling nervous, anxious, or really sad.
Four faces of the same person exhibit different emotions.
The last type of symptoms relate to sleep. You might have trouble falling and staying asleep. It could also be the opposite, and you might want to sleep a lot. So, now that you know what to look for, here are the four things to do if you think that you or your teammate has a concussion. 1. You have to stop the activity right away. This is a must. If you keep playing or practicing, you might make things a lot worse and can make your symptoms last longer.
A coach escorts a player off the field after the player experiences an impact.
2. Tell an adult you trust. Someone needs to call your parent or guardian if they're not with you.
Coach uses his cell phone.
3. You or your teammate should not be left alone with a suspected concussion.
As coach talks on phone, teammates support the player.
Finally, you'll need to be checked by a medical doctor or nurse practitioner as soon as possible.
With a doctor nearby, the player sits on a medical exam bench.
Remember, if you're hit, stop playing or practicing, and sit out.
Words on screen say, Rowans Law. Hit, stop, sit.
Now let's talk about how you can recover from a concussion. All concussions are different, so don't compare your recovery to someone else's. Still, there are some steps that everyone should follow to get better. Lots of people, especially athletes, get injured and have to rest and recover. If you hurt your knee, you can't run until it's healed and strong again, or else you might make things worse.
A hurdler recovers by resting their damaged knee.
It's the same with a concussion, except how do you rest and recover the brain? Since the brain is involved with pretty much everything you do, resting it requires taking a break in a few different ways. A person with a concussion shouldn't do anything that makes them feel worse.
A brain floats within a protective bubble.
This could mean less exercise, less screen time, or even less schoolwork. It's about letting your brain and body get better. While you're recovering, you should always let an adult know if you don't feel right or if your symptoms get worse. You'll need to follow a list of specific steps before you can return safely to school and physical activity. You should work with your medical doctor or nurse practitioner and other healthcare providers, your school and sports team, to make a plan that's just right for you to get better.
A booklet cover displays the title Rowans Law Plan, Specific Steps to Return Safely.
It's also important that you wait until a medical doctor or nurse practitioner says it's okay for you to return to full training, practice, or competition. Most plans start with 1 to 2 days of rest. Each step in the plan takes at least 1 day, but could take several days. Once you can do the activities in one step without new symptoms or feeling worse, you're usually ready to move to the next step. If symptoms do get worse at any step, you need to stop and rest. And if symptoms don't improve or if they keep getting worse, talk to an adult you trust. Remember, every concussion is different and a slow recovery doesn't mean you failed. It's just what you need to do to get better. On to the steps for returning to sports. Step 1 is light daily activities that don't make you feel worse.
Sweeping.
Step 2 is some light activity, like going for a short walk. Step 3 is specific exercises for your sport. Simple drills like shooting a basketball. No strength training and nothing that could cause any head or body contact.
A protective bubble forms around a person shooting hoops.
It's not until the 4th step that you can return to team practice and participate in harder drills and some strength training. There still shouldn't be any physical contact, and that's one of the many reasons why it's important the whole team understands and supports your recovery.
Now shooting hoops in a group, though the protective bubble remains.
Step 5 is returning to full practice. And step 6 is where you get back to regular gameplay or competition. Don't forget, you need the okay from a medical doctor or nurse practitioner before you can return to full practice, training, or competition. Check with your sports team and school for the specific steps that should be followed. And remember, returning to school comes first, before returning to playing sports. Athletes, parents, coaches, team trainers, officials, and teachers all have a part in preventing, recognizing, and managing concussions. Everyone needs to talk openly and understand the importance of letting others know if something doesn't feel right. Sports, physical activity, and exercise can play a big part in our lives, but our health comes first. If we recognize a concussion early and manage it properly, the brain can heal, just like any other part of the body.
A brain exhibits a very happy face.
Thanks for listening, and take care of your awesome brain.
This video is part of a series of Rowans Law Concussion Awareness Resources. Rowans Law was named for Rowans Stringer, a high school rugby player from Ottawa, who died in the spring of 2013 from a condition known as second impact syndrome, swelling of the brain caused by a subsequent injury that occurred before a previous injury healed. Rowan is believed to have experienced 3 concussions over 6 days while playing rugby. She had a concussion, but didn't know her brain needed time to heal. Neither did her parents, teachers, or coaches. These resources are not intended to provide medical advice relating to healthcare. For advice on healthcare for concussion symptoms, please consult with a physician or nurse practitioner.